great mind had this idea.
Look up and smile.
Oh.
I'm going to make some treatments. I need a welder.
No, Peter's welding that, or he says he's not welding it, so you might be welding it. I'm welding this. I got a weld in there.
Do you have any clamps or vice grip clamps?
Yeah.
Did you get it to weld?
You gonna weld?
I'm gonna weld it.
Oh.
But you're welding.
It's not great. Okay, I didn't know you actually wanted her to mess with this stuff or not. I don't mind having somebody else weld it because my welding is suspect. I'll be the first to tell you.
Suspect is a nice word for my welding.
I can stick stuff together, but... I even brought my welding helmet, but... I got one end high, so I wanted to tack one end down and then... clamp the other one and tack it down.
Are we going all the new one?
What's that? That's gonna work.
Yeah.
Alright, listen. You can run a beat all the way around that edge.
You know, I just realized I didn't double that. Is that okay? Okay, alright. Okay. I was going to double at least the lid, I forgot.
Alright, Josh, come here. So here's one can, another can, all filled up. Got 10,000 nickel in there in the patterns. You can't see because it's covered up with powder. Now there's two kinds of powder. There's actually three in this one. A couple in there. So we've got 1084 on the outside and then some, it looks like 1095 on the inside. We'll weld this on. It's got a little 16th hole in there for bent gas. Then we'll take a big piece of 1-inch square bar, about 3 feet long. We'll weld that onto the end of the can, and that'll be our handle. So in this one, we've got three kinds of powder, and it's kind of a skull outline thing. So we've got 1084, got 4600 KC, and then 1095 in some of the spots. So same thing. We'll get that welded on there. And we won't get these in the forge today, but should be able to get a bunch squished out tomorrow. We're also working on building the power hammer, so that's the priority. We're working on getting that going when we'll be squishing some metal tomorrow. This one over here, where'd that canoe go? Right here. So Les made a canoe. It had five sides. The top was open. He put a layer of ball bearings in there, and he ran them in oil. And then brushed them around and rolled them around in nickel powder so that nickel kind of sticks to those oily ball bearings.
Yeah.
Put a third of an inch layer in there, put a stick of 1084 in there, then put another layer of ball bearings on there, put the top of the can on. Liss is getting ready to weld this shut, and we'll drill a vent hole in there. But then this will all get squished down, and hopefully we get a nice ball bearing look on either side, and then a layer of 1084 in the middle for the cutting edge. The ball bearings in this case were just mild steel because this was going to be a sandwich thing.
So I switched to a lamp oil, like I said. And yeah. Lamp oil, it smells good, does the same thing.
What the hell?
What would happen if I took a cup and rolled up little pieces of nickel to stand up in them in circles, laid them in there, filled it in with 184 powder, and scratched that? What would that look like? Those tubes are going to get smashed this way instead of this way. That's right. What I'm wondering.
So they'll crinkle up.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I might not translate that.
Generally, no.